Did you know that you are able to rewire your brain to get stronger and have a more positive mindset? Believe it. How? Through neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity is the ability of our brain to create new pathways so that you can get stronger and get more function, or to strengthen pathways that are already existing. Let me explain a little bit further. Let's start with the example of having a difficult time lifting one of your legs up towards the ceiling. And this is something you would need to be able to do when you're sitting, to scoot yourself backwards or scoot yourself forward, or even lift to get into a car, lift to get into bed. So that lifting movement of your hip is actually very common, and you do it all the time throughout the day, whether you realize it or not. And one thing that is important to note is that in order for that movement to happen, there is a spot in your brain that fires and it sends a neural pathway all the way down to your hip that tells it to lift. Sometimes that pathway isn't working so well. That pathway may not be working at all, or maybe it's getting a little bit slower along the way, the myelin is deteriorating. For whatever reason, getting from here to here is not working. That's where neuroplasticity kicks in. What your brain does every single time you practice the movement of lifting your leg up is your brain finds a new way to get from point A to point B. So if you attempt to lift your leg up, let's say your brain starts here, it lights up, but your leg doesn't actually lift, then that pathway didn't work. So you attempt for a second time, you try to lift, lift, lift. Your brain might send a pathway that way, didn't work. Maybe you try it for the 500th time and your brain's gonna send a zigzag, and it works a little bit and it lifts just ever so slightly. Every time you practice that exercise from there on out, your brain is going to use that same pathway until it gets stronger and stronger, and you'll slowly be able to lift your leg a little bit higher. Now, let's say you can actually lift your leg a little bit. It's just not as good as the other side. Maybe your left side is nice and strong and your right side just lifts a tiny bit. That means that you do have a pathway from point A to point B that's working. It's just not strong, meaning you need to practice the exercise over and over again in order to strengthen that pathway that is already working. The trick to make this actually happen for you so that you can get stronger is practice, practice, practice. If you're not practicing, your brain is not finding new connections or strengthening the connection that's already there. You can use this same concept of neuroplasticity for strengthening your muscles as you can for mindset. And you can actually retrain your brain to be more positive by creating neural pathways. There are many different strategies that you can use to create a more positive mindset through neuroplasticity, and I'll tell you just one right now. Anytime you are thinking about something negative and you're feeling that negative emotion, whether it's something about yourself, something about someone you know, something about the world, immediately stop yourself from thinking about that and replace that with a thought that is more positive. And that positive thought likely is different for everyone. It could be something as small as a nice sunny day, or a crisp breeze through the air, or snuggling with your dog. It can be anything in the world that makes you super happy and fulfilled and grateful. And anytime you're thinking a negative emotion, replace it with that positive one. And you are literally retraining your brain to find more positive pathways. So if you're suffering from weakness in your body, and if you're suffering from a negative mindset, using the concepts of neuroplasticity will allow you to get stronger and get a more positive mindset. The way that you can do this is by watching more of my videos from YouTube that go over specific exercises that you can do that are functional in order to improve neuroplasticity pathways, as well as join the Missing Link virtual physical therapy program specifically for multiple sclerosis. And practice positive thinking daily, multiple times a day, as often as you can, to replace those neural connections and find one that works for you. If you found this video helpful and you liked it, please remember to press the thumbs up button, share it with a friend, and subscribe. Lastly, check the description below so that you can find information on the other exercise videos I referred to and the Missing Link website.